PS1 style is something that I have been influenced with when making my low poly models. However, I have only been able to make one model that could fit the PS1 aesthetic. So, for this video, I tried to make an experiment and try to make a model that is a lot more faithful to the PS1 style. I am still somewhat fatigued with my week's stretch of commissions, so I just wanted to make a very simple and fun model for now. I first thought of making Chloe Price from the Life is Strange series, since she looks pretty cool, and as a character, I thought that she could translate really well in a PS1 style. Plus, if you know who she is, then you know why I find her cool. When I made the proportions for this specific model, one of the things that I changed is how I made my hips or pelvis. I learned from an actual PS1 model that all you have to do in order to make the hips not look weird while being in proportion was to make it into a cone. No need to model any other thing for the inner part of the thighs. I also learned the importance of using triangles over quads or squares. Basically, it gives you more control with the angles that the model can be viewed from. Quads can sometimes bend or fold in ways that you don't really want, so using triangles helps solve that problem. While making the other parts of the model, everything else was pretty standard. Cubes for blocking out proportions, then replacing it with cylinders. However, what I didn't expect was how difficult it is to make a singular mesh for the hand. I thought that since it would be just one mesh, that it would be easier. Well, I am able to make hands in a single mesh, but trying to be much more faithful with the PS1 style just made it much more complex for me, if that makes sense. I ended up just importing the hand model from an actual PS1 model. Making the face was the same as before, so I would be skipping some of its process. However, I want to give more attention with the nose and the ears. I recently have been making low poly faces with embedded noses and ears. As you can see here from our real PS1 model, everything including the hair is in one mesh. If people were able to make that in the 90s, then surely I would be able to make it as well. Though I was able to do the ears and nose, I still separated the hair since that is still the method that I am very comfortable with. Plus, I didn't want to stitch meshes for half a day. The hair is pretty easy actually. Since there isn't much spikes or hairs that go through different directions, I was able to simplify the hair to its bare PS1 minimum polygon. Also, triangles make hair easier to make, so I recommend you guys to try and use triangles a bit more. The shoes, on the other hand, were very much simple and pretty self-explanatory. For texturing, I found a tutorial with how to UV map in Blockbench. It was from a channel called the Haxman in YouTube, and there it was explained how you would be able to use the M-Tool plugin to make your mappings a lot easier. I will leave a link in the description, but if you guys want me to make a tutorial on this, you may comment it down and let me know. The texturing was not as easy as I thought it would be. If you were to look at a real texture file for a PS1 model, though it is all in a 256 by 256 file, all of the textures were detailed and complex. Me being not so great with pixel art made it a lot harder for me to capture the real PS1 look. I struggled with making the skin look more natural and appealing. Later, I even imported some skin palettes to help me, but even that didn't really help. The same problems were present with the hair, only that it was much more manageable for me. Other than that, I didn't want to push myself to make a very great texture since I've been making models for the past weeks and I needed a break from it. So the rest of the texturing phase, I just roughly placed the major details onto the model. And with all that, here's what the semi-finished model looks like. All in all, I think that it really is possible to make a faithful PS1 character in Blockbench. I think that with all the tools it currently has, everyone would be able to make one. Sure, it may not be easy, but with a bit more effort and practice, it is possible. I would also like to thank everyone who has commissioned me for the past weeks. It was a great experience and I will be opening commissions again soon. I enjoyed the process and the grind to make models. I also want to thank everyone who follows me and has subscribed to my YouTube channel. We have reached the 1.5k subscriber milestone. I do apologize for the lesser uploads, but I will try to upload whenever I can. So with that, thank you to all of you, I appreciate all of you, and see you in the next video.